Seems we're trapped. Welcome to part two. I'm gonna link this one and also put a playlist. But, yeah. Part two. This stupid let's play. Best character is Amanda. Alrighty, so episode two. Last time we did the tutorial. That was kind of it. And now we are in the prison of Doggo. Last time, yeah, we did the, I don't know, you can dig here, that's new. So yeah, last time we did the tutorial and Ordar Village, and now we get to do whatever I feel like doing in this part, too. Yeah, I know the audio quality is dog shit, but I don't know how to fix it, so you get to live with it. Probably turn down the game audio a bit. Because, like, it's too loud here. Whatever. I don't really feel like talking to people, I don't need to. Alright, you don't have to go this way. So yeah, basically you gotta go around, lift up this to bring in some water, go reverse around, swim over these spikes, and then do the same. Here, yeah, you just kind of see Minda do stupid Minda magic. Oh, that camera angle was weird. Oh, what a good dig spot. Okay, that way. Runny. I do it a runny fast. It's no mad, no way, but it's good. That was an entire heart of damage there. Stupid. So now we are outdoors in wherever we are. Spoiler, it's in Hyrule Castle. Yeah. Let's just go. Out here, yeah, it's not much. It's mostly just a straight, okay, shut up, Minda. It's mostly just a straight path out here to the end. The AoE attack. Just forget about that. That was too close for comfort, I'm gonna lie. Okay. Awful. Nice to put some air back here. Alright, word of warning. Don't be a stupid idiot. Fire does one heart of damage. Anyways.
Thank you.
There's the title of the game. Roll credits. Zelda, you pissed off like Din, probably. So shocking, Midna almost fell off of his back. Also, this is the most lazy characterized Zelda out of all of them. She appears like 3 times in the entire game. Off we go.
You'll be completely
question is, how does Midna know about Ilya and Colin? And there he goes. Big black the wall. Anyways, so we're just gonna go this way. So yeah, Midna gives us our goal, and we gotta go find the sword and shield. Thankfully, Wolfling's attacks are about as strong as right in between the Warden's sword and the Master sword, I believe. Although I could easily be wrong, it could just be as strong as Warden's sword. Oh, and yeah, there's this one little squirrel dude here. Anyway, so off I go. Into hot take the best section of the game. So yeah, there's that dude up there. Basically your goal is to get inside the house over there to get the shield and get inside Russell's house for the sword. Yeah, that orange rupee I was talking about last episode. Nah, you can't see it from this angle. See it from here, or maybe not, I don't know, but it should be back there. Right, I'm gonna go around. Bad angle there. Oh, why is the sword not in here? Sword should have been in there. I guess you have to do sneak up the, like, Mayor and Russell first. Thank you. village is full of idiots. Oh, that's a mood, Minna. I thought they're just like monsters from the Discord, or just a wolf, which is like a normal animal. Which doesn't make sense. So you gotta try for the kid. So yeah, you have to, after you get talked to, listen to those guys, you have to sneak up here. Get him from behind. And you never see him again. He's dead. Spaghetti never forgetting. Where did you jump in? How do they even have that window open? Like, legit question. Like, they don't have a ladder or something. Why am I just spin attacking? Sheldon. I'm gonna try. Actually, you know what would be fun? I'm gonna try using just the Ordin sword and shield for the entire game. Just cause challenge extra. So yeah, now you have to come around into this house and get the sword. I bet that's was the devs talking and not just the frog. Honestly, because that's like just funny. This situation alone should give me an insane distrust of the fountain spirits. Anyways, quick kill. You just have to kill this one, this portal. RGB PCs at night. that directly contradicts the fact that, like, the regular people don't know the Twilight is here. So I just realized, but this is one of the only times in the game the Great Fairy theme plays. Fuck. Also, spin attacks are awful in here. Alright. I'm usually not this bad at this game. But like... holy shit. Possible to tell attack. Honestly, the Wii version had better combat.
Keep your
being,
power.
So yeah, if we just ignore that little fucker, then let's continue. I should not have skipped over all that. Yeah, basically this orc, this Farona's like, oh, I'm all dead and shit. Go get the bugs. Now we gotta go get the bugs. I love the bugs. Use sense. Fuck bugs. Then cook them. I hate that stupid scarecrow. It automatically targets it for some reason. I much prefer Skyward Swords, Tears of Iron section. I should play Skyward Sword through again soon. And I'd probably do pick up this channel. Comment if you'd want to see me do pick up too. On this channel. Wii version. Spectre 2 is an awesome game. So now we're off this way. There's no bugs in the cave, so here's an eagle trick you might not know. This cave is a dig spot that lets you skip it. It just sticks you right at the north end, and you can run through to the foggy area, or gassy, or whatever the hell it is. I was wondering if that stuff was. Alright, so that's that. Now we gotta do this area basically is your Wolfling playground. It's kind of a playground area for pretty much every item in the game. And this is your playground for Wolfling. That was stupid. I forgot to hit the button. I think it does good damage. It just wipes you out. Okay, got it. Why don't you rush? Now they're underground. That is quick. They weren't that they could just play Minecraft before. Thank you. kind of warp like speed in a jumping pipe. Whether or not Scott the Waz will ever finish the Minish Cap. And if he does, I hope he does it while constantly talking about the elephant. There's only two here. Well, there was three. Here, there's nothing you can do unless you missed that chest earlier. Come back to this area like four times in the game. And yeah, these are the last two bugs up in the forest temple. Hopefully you can still get the tears in a cutscene. Anyway, so here's Munko. Munko 1. Yeah, grab that, and you're done with Fairy Twilight. Easiest and shortest Twilight, and also a tutorial. As everything is in the first 2 hours of this game. So yeah. Monkey. That was for Rona. From like the spirits. Now he has hands. He wants to go back. I thought it was just like the hero. So yeah, basically this dude just gives you the green clothes and tells you, fuck you, go to the forest temple. And he's still just like, whoa, hands. Alright, so... So yeah. I'm gonna end off episode 2 here. Thanks for watching. And I'll see you probably tomorrow.